In this lesson, we're going to learn how to approximate area under curves. Specifically, we're going to use one curve. This will obviously extend to more. Y equals x squared plus 1. And we're going to always go from x equals 1 to x equals 3. So we're going to try to find the area, which is this area. But we're going to use four different approximation methods, since we currently don't know how to find the exact area. So, first approximation method is with left-hand rectangles. What I mean by left-hand rectangles is we're going to put four rectangles. Oh, and every time, actually, I should note, we're going to use four objects. So, in this case, we'll use four rectangles. And when I say left-hand, the height of the rectangle is going to be determined by where its left side meets the curve. You can see that this is definitely an under approximation. That's because the function's going up, so the left-handed rectangles are going to always end up under the curve. So for example, this rectangle, its height is determined by what f of 2.5 is. So each rectangle, the area, is base times height. Each base is 1/2. And the height of the first one is f of 1. And then the next one is 1/2 times f of 1.5. And 1/2 times f of 2. And 1/2 times f of 2.5. And if you add all that up, it's going to give us the area of all the green stuff. Yes, you could factor out 1/2. So you could do, I'm just using a dot, dot, dot for brevity here. But you could pull 1/2 out of everything. I'll leave you to calculate that. It turns out to be 8.75. To calculate what f of 1 is, remember that you're on the curve y equals x squared plus 1. So, for example, f of 1 is 1 squared plus 1, or 2. F of 1.5 will be 1.5 squared plus 1, which will be 3 1/4. So you add them up and you get this as your approximate area. Okay, now for right rectangles. I'm just going to make some space here. For right rectangles, we're going to draw our rectangles in a way that has the right edge of the rectangle determining its height. So the first rectangle will start at 1.5 and go over, then at 2 and go over, at 2.5, and then the last one is corresponding to 3. So each rectangle again is of width 1/2. So this time I'm going to factor the 1/2 out right from the start. Now the height of this rectangle is f of 1.5. Notice we're not using 1 at all here. And then f of 2, f of 2.5, so I'm now on this rectangle. Height is f of 2.5, and the height of the last one's f of 3. And you can do this calculation. You'll notice that this time we used a 3, whereas this on the first example, we used left endpoints, so we ended up using 2.5 instead of 3. Here, you'll also notice that we started at 1.5 as opposed to starting at 1. If you calculate this, you'll get 12.75. I hope you'd agree that for the area that we're trying to approximate, which is the area underneath the curve, that a left-hand rectangle method will give you an under-approximation, 8.75. So we know the actual area is bigger than that. Right-handed rectangles will give you 12.75, which is an over-approximation, because the green rectangles live above, in all cases, the curve. So we're going to look for a compromise. One compromise is the midpoint rule. So at the midpoint, we're still taking four objects. But rather than use 1, 1.5, 2, 2.5, and 3, our first rectangle is in the middle of 1 and 1.5. And then its height is determined based on 1 1/4. in the middle of 1.5 and 2 is 1.75. In the middle 2 and 2.25 is 2 1/4. And then 2 3/4 would be this last one. So to write the area, each rectangle is again of width 1/2 or 0.5, goes from 1 to 1.5. So the area here will be 1/2. And now we just have to figure out the height of each rectangle. Well, the first rectangle, is height is determined by the middle of 1 and 1 1/2, which is 1 1/4. So we do f of 1 1/4. Then 1 3/4. And then between 2 and 2 1/2, we use this as the middle, which is 2 1/4. And then 2 1/2 to 3, we use 2.75. And if you calculate that, you'll get somewhere in the middle of 8.75 and 12.75. And as long as I did this right, you'll get 10.625. Now, is it an under or over approximation? Not really sure. It looks like there's little pieces that stick out above the curve, and there's also little parts that stick or that remain below the curve. So it's not quite determined if it's above or below the approximation. But this 10.625 should be pretty close to the actual area. Okay. The last technique is to use trapezoids. So again, we're using four objects. So what we do is we connect both left and right. It's kind of like left and right rectangles, but we're going to use both left and right side, and we'll determine a trapezoid. So these trapezoids involve the use of all four numbers, and as you'll see, the use of all four numbers multiple times. So each rectangle, or each trapezoid, has a width of 1/2, and the formula for the area of the trapezoid involves multiplying the average of the bases, or the average of the heights, times the base. So we need to average the height of 1 1/2. So we take f of 1 and f of 1.5. And so this average here will give you an average height of that trapezoid, and we multiply it by its base size. And we can repeat this. I'll just do the last one as well, which is 1/2 f of 2.5 plus f of 3. I'm just going to write that a little bigger. Over 2. And you'll see that in each term there's 1/2. And they're all divided out by 2. So in this case, we can factor out 1/4. You can't always factor out 1/4. But you will notice that this guy's got an f of 1. This f of 1.5 is going to be used by the first trapezoid and the second trapezoid. So we'll have double 1.5. This 2 will be used by both, or two trapezoids. So will 2.5. What I mean is 2.5 is the right edge of this trapezoid, and it's the left edge of our last trapezoid, whereas the number 3, just like 1, is only used one time. And then you can calculate all of that and get 10.75. So this was all based on one calculation, this, which was the area of the trapezoid, and then I just quickly extended it to be the area of all four trapezoids. Add it up. And you can see because the curve is increasing and concave up, the trapezoids are just slightly above the curve, in which case 10.75 is an over approximation. So we have a lot of estimates here. It's going to be really close to 10 3/4. If you wanted to find the actual area, you would just integrate. And if you do that, you'll find that the real area is 10 2/3. So to recap, rectangles based on their left side heights, rectangles based on right side heights, just four simple calculations. This was making rectangles, but making the middle of each rectangle determine the height. And then the last one was kind of using a left and right endpoint, thus making a trapezoid because the bottom, the walls here of the trapezoid are parallel, and the base and the height are not in this case. So then we had to build it on an area of a trapezoid model. So you can do this a lot better and exactly using integration, and we'll get to that sometime soon. So you'll be responsible for all four methods.